night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
Hold it a minute, that was your first mistake. I'm stirring here around like crazy to get these Christmas babies ready. There's no rest for this hard-working mouse.
The stockings were hung by the chimneys with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
Oops, mistake number two. Those socks were hung by the fireplace to dry out. Those kids can't seem to stay out of wet snow.
The children and Aslan snuck in the bed while missing some sugar plums.
They are.
Sugar plums, sugar plums. Those kids are dreaming about gifts. Gifts and stuff and things. They don't care if it dances or not. They just want the loot.
Mr. Mouse, you certainly seem negative. Are you a little disturbed by Christmas?
Christmas? Bah, humbug. It's all about worship, worry, loot, bills. Give me anything. Got it?
Let me grab the first edition of The Night Before Christmas and see if that will help you understand. Now settle down and listen. Twas the night before Christmas, and up in the sky the angels were prepping to be heard on high.
Why did it say, I didn't say that.
Nice to know God is sending Jesus down to earth.
I'm so excited for Christmas till first.
Let me look at our assignment scroll. We have to go to the hills outside of Bethlehem to a group of shepherds.
Shepherds? Didn't you tell some important people?
It's God's plan for you to tell the shepherds first. The Bible is just the beginning of the plan.
Well, God knows best. Let's get the other angels and head out. Lead on, Gabriel.
Thank you. let's go and look for the stable.
The Lord will take care of the sheep. Let's hurry.
So after the angels delivered the news, the shepherds went searching with no time to lose. And just as the angels had told them aloud, they found Jesus with Mary and Joseph so proud.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that any census should be taken of the entire world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David. Because he belonged to the house and line of David, he went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
No.
And there were sheep, shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those who his favor rests."
Jesus, and joy, and look straight from God.
Congratulations, now.